Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Nazrin, and welcome to my first ever vlog that I made just for my public speaking assessment. And now, I'm gonna tell you about a social issue in which regarding animal abuse among society and how animal abuse affects the society. Stay tuned. Animal abuse is defined as the crime inflicting physical pain, suffering the death of an animal, usually the tame one, beyond necessity of normal discipline. So animal cruelty is truly sickening issue among people. This is how cruel people are towards animals. Animal abuse is like a tip of iceberg in which defined by the way animals are regarded in a family is a window into interpersonal relationships and family dynamics. So you guys can see how animal abuse is look like the iceberg. So now guys, I will provide you 2 points on how animal abuse can affect the society. For the first one, animal abuse can affect the society by being the starting point of any other crime. The second point is, animal abuse can be the cause of family violences. So stay tuned. We move to my first argument in which animal cruelty is the beginning of any other crimes. Abuses towards animals done by family members, especially the parents, are easily copied by the children as they are in the development process. According to SPCA, based on national crime statistics, 100% of serial killers have involved in animal abuse. This statistic has been supported by the juvenile statistic in which first experience of abusing animals started at the age of 6 until 12. There are several examples of abuses that turn into a serial killer. So guys, a friendly advice from me. Stop abusing animals or not, you might be a serial killer. So now, we move to the second point on animal abuse, in which animal cruelty can be the cause of family violence. Animal abuses often be shown by the parents to show how powerful they are toward their children. The children will be punished the same as animals or family pets if they do the wrong thing. Animal abuse is a form of power and control used to manipulate, intimidate, and retaliate against others in domestic violence. In a national survey at the US of battered women's shelters, 85% of shelters reported that women seeking services at safe house talk about the incidents of pet abuse. And also, it will affect the future generation of leaders that might apply cruelty in administration because of your previous fault. So never, ever, ever abuse animals. There is a model of power and control that have been used widely nowadays in a domestic violence field in which called as Duluth model of power and control. So you guys can see how it works. So guys, friendly advice. Again, if you love your family, never abuse animals, okay? Okay guys, we reached to the end of my vlog. But, before that, you guys must watch a video that shows the comment from Pengarah Bahagian Konservasi Biodiversity Jabatan Perlindungan Dr. Pazil
bagi statistik yang melibatkan kezaliman hidupan liar di bawah Akta 716 dari tahun 2011 hingga 2017 adalah 10 kes dan ia melibatkan berbagai spesies antaranya adalah pangolin, babi hutan, biawak, beruk dan juga beberapa spesies burung.
So guys, in conclusion, animal abuse is a part of intergenerational cycle of violence. Children living in homes with domestic violence and animal abuse absorb unhealthy attitudes and family norms and hand these values down to their own children when they grow up. Based on Islamic perspective, we have been taught by Prophet to give respect and love each other as the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Based on the hadith, which Prophet said that whoever kind to the creatures of the God is kind to himself. So, you love others, you love yourself. So guys, it is end of my vlog. Stay tuned for my next entry maybe. And inshallah, till we meet again. Bye bye.